hit it too soon. I hit it too goddamn soon. Fuck me. Really? Oh, well. Oh, no. Yep. This ain't great. Wait. Oh, no. He's going to crush me up. He's going to crush me up real bad. You know, this really reminds me of my my playthrough of Until Dawn, where I thought I was doing pretty well, and then I blew everybody up at the end. Fucking shit. Oh, man. Who's pounding on my chamber window door? Jamie? Oh, no. If Jamie's in there, she might get crushed. It's not Mark.
Get in here.
Yeah, okay. I think we're going to lose Jamie pretty soon then. God, fucking that heartbeat thing. That heartbeat thing.
What the hell is this?
Need to focus.
Pleased to see you too, Kate.
Now the textures are having a hard time loading in.
Have you seen Mark? No. I've seen Demet though. He's creeping around.
Well, not the Dume that we know of. Well, fuck, there's two of us. We might be able to take him. Hey, finally, somebody reaching out and not letting a door close. Does he have a fucking elevator system that helps him get from floor to floor to floor? Where does it get to the crushing room?
Jesus.
Yeah, this seems really, really advanced.
He's got video feeds, recording decks, a mixer big enough for countless mics.
Couple of fucking servers.
He's got utilities running through here, hydraulics, electrics, everything. He can control the whole building from here.
How far down does it go?
This all connects. This is how he's getting around the house.
Okay, we got a third level, second level. God damn.
I would say this guy is a fractured psyche. That he's wearing a mask to put what he's doing on a different personality.
That's probably just his theory because he can't reconcile a human doing this stuff.
And this is where Charlie just died. Well, practically 10 feet away. Shit.
What is that?
They finally give me gameplay. To hit buttons, I fuck it up. God damn it.
There was no groundskeeper.
Well, you saw a guy in a yellow jacket with her stuff.
I guess that was Mr. Demet.
I think it's a mistake to say he's just crazy. He is in full control of what he's doing.
Okay, bitch, I can't get past you and your giant lumbering ass. Fuck.
That's not crazy.
Crazy implies
stairwell
out of
going up.
Look at this place. This is methodical. That's not crazy. No.
Subject order reference.
Wait, he's wearing the mask as part of the performance. At best, maybe he's insecure about something and it gives him confidence.
Insecure.
From Amber Harris to Brandon Day. Thank you, Brandon. Okay, bitch is still going. Fuck. You bitch is done?
Bad parenting
nope.
Definitely be a factor.
I'll wait.
But it could be a shitty dad just as much, or an uncle, any adult figure, really.
Thank you, Brandon. I've instructed our marker maker to proceed. We will keep you updated on progress with photographs at each stage as promised. As discussed previously, we'll keep the production discreet. Thanks, Amber.
As an adult, he's either an extreme overachiever or a cipher. Nothing between.
Good morning, Amber. Thank you for your reply and putting my mind at rest. Yes, the cost is perfectly fine. Please go ahead. Reminder, this should remain confidential.
Lots of people put up with that stuff and don't turn into killers.
Aside from the unhealthy obsession with H.H. Holmes?
H.H.
Copying the M.O.
Cute.
Clearly, he identifies with Holmes somehow.
Good morning, Brandon. I can assure you that all of the custom masks are very robust. Yep, there are multiple people.
Maybe
custom masks.
Open those shutters in the lobby.
Yeah. They are often used in long-running theater productions and filming intense action scenes. The material used for your mask is a plastic resin-coated wood, which provides a toughened strength and is highly durable, so smashing them in the face isn't going to hurt them too much. The total would be $1,800, excluding taxes. Can you let me know if this is acceptable, and I will instruct our maker to proceed. Thanks, Amber. So there are multiple dudes walking around in this production. Yeah. What is this? Chicago police officer badge.
Chicago police. Mr. Monday, this is Chicago police.
So it is potentially Monday.
Mr. Monday, I'm Officer Stanley with Chicago Police Department. Can you hear me, sir? Agent Monday.
We got a call from your friend, Agent Saturday.
Dispatch, this is Officer Stanley. I need assistance at 8 West 50th Street, requesting immediate backup. I'm in Agent Monday's apartment. There's blood everywhere and a body. I need immediate support.
Indistinguishable body. Not Monday, potentially. Monday being the killer. And yeah, that's one of his victims. Killed that Chicago cop. Interesting. Big thumbprint there. Watching each and every one of the rooms. Okay, girl, you need to not get in the way, because goddamn, getting around you is awful.
He's been tracking us since we arrived.
The Lonnet crew. Charlie, Aaron, Mark, Jamie, Kate. Huh. So, probably have to take that stairwell over here to be able to get to another floor. Seems like the only path to, move along. Shit. Actually, do I want to... Well, no. You read that Mark was in the basement. So, going down is most likely the plan of action. But I want to go up to the third level. See what we got here for more lore, more items to discover. Now that these people are going to live very fucking long with how my performance has been so far. It's a tape recorder. Or maybe you just record them somewhere else. So, is the killer an actual fanatic of H.H. Holmes, or is it Officer Mundy? Well, that's a hard progression right there, pressing that X, is it? Can I actually head to the basement? Is there something blocking me from going all the way down there? Or would that call like the elevator? Let's take a... No? Ooh. Okay, this is going really far down. This is going a hell of a lot further than... I don't know. It just goes to that and kind of ends here. Okay. Thank God they have that icon that's like, hey, Ben, this is hard progression here, so if you want to press this, good luck looking at anything else. I prefer that over the, hey, let's walk into a specific spot and not be able to look at anything. Open the book. Let's open the book. Thank you. Oh, my goodness.
This is everything about me. Jesus.
Jamie Tiergan. Da-da-da. Running Waters Medical Facility. A medical clinic where she was born? Lonnet Entertainment. Self-destructive tendencies and impulsive. For Kate Wilder, we got PTSD. Medication. A bunch of American medications that I would not recognize. Um, An inhaler for Aaron. Fortunately, she's dead as shit. Why does Mark have the word ferryman written under his face there? But for Aaron, what is that word? Self-conceited? Self-confidence issues. Confidence. That F looks like a fucking T. Recently treated for arachnophobia. So if Mark is still alive, we may have a big spider section. Fucking yay! Charlie, smoker, borderline narcissist, has been ground into bits, unfortunately. Fuck. So, was doing some research on us. Nothing too major, but mainly just medical backgrounds and psychological profile analysis. Which, you know, a police or a FBI profiler for serial killers might be familiar with how to profile people. June Collins? Every time I see a J, it looks like a T. 41 years old, open-minded, simple to coerce, healthy, seemingly no major health issues, within 1,000 kilometers. Nuclear family of five, estranged extended family, fluent in Spanish and French, ambidextrous, travels a lot, runs late at night, runs when traveling as well. Andrew Collins.
Are we?
No, there's been multiple. 38 years old, average build, did amateur boxing, deal with first. Unknown medical condition, follow up on this. Right-handed, insecure, small but close extended family, will they call them? One parent deceased, other ill, medical bills, pressure, caffeine addict. Is that it? That's all? Previous victims. Oh, we can't get the pencil again. Thank you for, you know, telling me that there's a pencil feature. Okay. Michelle initially appeared excited, becoming increasingly agitated, rarely alone, more difficult to separate her. Wandered the hotel later last night, opportunity. Bathed away from family room, noticeably tired towards the end of the day, drink socially, use this, heavy sleeping pills. Target her at the end of the day, gave wine and sleeping pills when bathing, separate her. Harrison Lee, death via asphyxiation, reset trap before the next group arrives. Lewis Lee, drowned, fish body out of pool. Cecile Hall, death from blood loss after implement on a sundial. Impalement on a sundial, sorry. Body disposed of. Kurt Hall, multiple gunshot wounds. Thomas Hall, single gunshot wound, execution. Keeping records of how they died as well. Very thorough. Incredibly thorough. Jeez. All right, back up the stairs and let's hit that. Actually, 1 second before I go up the stairs. There's a platform leading into what seems to be the elevator here. But I imagine there's no interactables for any of that. It's most likely set off from that button up on the third floor. This is just learning about all the people who are gonna die, not including... God damn it, Jamie. Fucking spook a person a little bit, being in the dark, dark shadows like that. Charlie and... God damn it, I've forgotten the Indian girl's name already. She was the first to die, but that doesn't mean she should be the first to be forgotten, for fuck's sakes. It's, Aaron. Aaron, yes. So those doors...
Over here!
Or those walls move that way.
Look at this. It's all his little tricks of moving walls and crap.
Nothing in this shit box is real. He controls everything from here. It's a murder factory.
You're right.
With his little raspberry pies.
All right. What's your plan?
Okay, look. He's in here, right?
Maybe.
So we get him to go down this hall, and we trap him between these two moving walls. There's no other way out of there.
That gets him real close to the door that enters the central section past four.
One of us is going to have
to be bait.
Gotta love it. Mm-hmm.
No way. It's too risky, Jamie.
So is letting him run free. I'd say that's more dangerous. Come on.
There's no second chances here.
This is a hefty gamble.
My plan. I'll be the bait.
We should have maybe jumped him when he came out of this room.
If it looks like it's going south, get the hell out of there.
No argument here.
You should keep that.
You could use that as a weapon if need be.
I'm gonna hang on to it. I'm more likely to need it.
Wow, these two, they were always at each other's throats, and now they have to cooperate and work together.
Stick to the plan,
obviously.
So how do we get out?
Try, but this is going to be a lot of improv. So all the doors lock automatically, and...
Okay, be ready. You have to time it right to trap him and not me.
Oh, fuck, this is going to be... Oh, boy. Timing?
All right.
Fantastic.
Here goes nothing.
Jamie, you're a dead woman. I'm sorry. Nope. She's gonna get crushed. This is how she gets crushed. Fuck. If only there was like a walkie-talkie or something that we could use to communicate with each other. Hey, fucking nothing like right behind you to hide one of these. Dog. And 63, a two-pointer. Grand. So, do I want to just go lumbering about? Because
head down the hall.
Faster we get into the sequence, the, well, sooner we'll get to the QTEs of me trying to fucking... Wait. Ooh. Want to look through that broken wall. This seems like a little bit more of a dilapidated section that we haven't seen yet.
Was this on the map?
Oh no, don't say stuff like that. There are sections and rooms that we are not familiar with, and maybe this person is. Which is a bit of a disadvantage for us. What do we got? There's something, there's a shiny on that bucket, was it? No, imagination. Hope. That's what it was. It's my hopes and dreams. Okay, why do we... Sure. Spook? Big spook. Mannequin. Oh, God. Even worse. Just a fucking mirror. And we're going for the shimmies. Great. Shimmy situations are... No, they're... You time it wrong, and... People being crushed. Hey, another coin. Ooh, this one looks gold. Might be a tenner? That was a tenner. Yes. There's a reason why my head's on a swivel all the time. There's that, but there's also this as well. Is he? Oh. Fucker. I was looking at the door closing. No reaction on that, girl. Nothing. Nothing at all. Oh, couldn't be happier. Couldn't be happier. Fuck yeah. Oldest trick in the book. Having him just walk right by, right in front of you. My heart kind of hurts after that one. Not gonna lie. Shit. Okay, so he was just in here. Just in here. But... Imagine that's the door. No, that is not the door I'm going through. Where are you, you fucker? Of course you're through that. Wait. Oh, this is that office where Aaron was hiding in the cupboard. Yeah. Oh, wait. No, I came through that door. I'm like, did I just come out that fucking cupboard where Aaron was hiding? So this is going to be the silver infirmary area.
Shit.
Okay, well, how is this going to play out? We run in hitting buttons. Which ones we using for it? And when are we going to be swapping over to Kate to start moving walls and shit? I'm prepared. I'm being ready for this. That doesn't mean I'm going to do a good job, though, but I'm going to be somewhat prepared. Fuck, he is right there like Jason Voorhees. We gotta run. He's real fast, though. Maybe I should have bluffed? Ooh, nope. Maybe you should have bluffed. I should have said, wait. Alright. Well, now he's kind of in on the game, and he's going to start going for the doors for that central area, right? Big dark area just off to your right. You got to be careful about that. He knows the layout of this place better than anybody. Oh, fuck. Coming out of the shadows like that, though. Very good. Very well. We haven't gotten crushed yet. Oh, shit.
Jamie, fucking run.
Oh, well, this turned out in a way that wasn't expected.
Oh, God.
But anticipated.
Fuck.
I don't think we should go into that house of horrors, but also being right here is not great for us either. No, okay, not the time for that. None of this tripping bullshit. Does he have some sort of remote controlling? Or did he wander? No, now we're separated. That's fucking great. Oh, what? Okay. And crushing. Yep. Yeah. Okay, I think I've walked into this. No, literally, have walked into this.
What is it?
It's a big red button.
There's a reverse symbol on it. What is it? Shit, no!
Pulling this shit again, hey? I kept the screwdriver, though. Wait, can I fuck up the button? No, do I want to fuck up the button? Oh, what do you think you're gonna do if you can't, she can't even scratch it with a screwdriver? And the reverse button is a one-way
Jamie!
Thing. Oh,
Jamie,
God.
If this thing, the wall will go the other way.
But
towards me?
Yeah, can't.
This thing will kill me if I don't press it. Wait! I know! If I do press it, then you're the one that dies.
Damn
Dumet! This is exactly what he wants. He's making you choose which one of us dies.
Yeah, I've already done that once. But I have to hit that button. Maybe there'll be a way I can short out the mechanism. Yeah. Defiant, I'm not playing this game. I know what happens. I get crushed.
I'm sorry, I have to.
There's not this, I'm not playing this game. There's, I'm going to be fucking crushed. Yeah, we're going to press that. Now, is there something I can do from my end, or have I 100% ensured the death of Kate here? Come on now. There has to be an option. There has to be something.
It's not on you. You hear me?
Or is she just gonna get... Okay, we're going to do nothing and watch her get fucking crushed?
Jamie, I don't wanna die.
Oh, how graphic is this gonna be? Well, I avoided that one death, but... Ooh! You seem disappointed.
What an excruciating way to go. Jamie pressed the button to kill Kate. I know they didn't always see eye to eye, but I didn't think she'd be that cold-blooded.
Well, I've seen her die once already.
Jamie chose not to save Erin when she could. Leaving her to die, deprived of oxygen, suffocating to death.
Yeah, Jamie got a lot of kills under her today.
Escaped the furnace, only to fall straight into Jumet's grasp.
Fuck that heartbeat thing, okay? I think I've been successful 50% of the time with that.
The hint I gave you earlier helped.
No, I had no clue what it was.
Perhaps you'd like another.
Yeah, fuck sure. Can it not be a fucking 8-stage, 300-year-old riddle?
Let's see if Sir Arthur can help us.
He didn't.
This
is
from The Man with the Twisted Lip.
What?
Have you read it?
No.
You should.
Okay.
A trusty comrade is always of use, and a chronicler still more so. I think that last bit might refer to me. You should get back. I hope these chats are helpful.
They're not.
I wouldn't want them to be intimidating.
No, they just...
I'll be watching your progress, as always.
So I got two people left.
Very closely.
Jamie and Mark. But what is going to happen with Mark? And reading that arachnophobia file... really doesn't fucking... I'm not looking forward to that. I'm not happy about the idea of that. Now, how did her head get crushed before any more of her body? Well, maybe, actually. Whew. So with my screwdriver, there's nothing I could do. Yeah, Jamie, you're a bit of a hardcore killer. One more, and you'll be a serial killer, Jamie. In a sense. Fuck. And here comes H.H. Holmes! Wow, we're really kind of running towards the end of this, aren't we? Here's Mark. Hey, Mark. Oh, hi, Mark. Shit. Please. Somebody has to make out of this alive, right? Right? You know? The idea of, two out of five ain't bad? No, three out of five ain't bad. That's what the real fucking line is. Oh my god. Oh. Did you break my camera, you motherfucker? Damn it. My whole photography career is destroyed. Thank God there's tons of cameras throughout this whole building. Mark doesn't know about that yet, but... be able to figure out eventually. Some Batman Arkham shit going through the venting. I'm venting? I'm sus? Oh, no, wait. There's probably traps in the vents. No? Maybe? Oh, what rusty, shithole, spider-laden environment is this going to be? I saw that there was a achievement for getting to the lighthouse. I don't think that's gonna happen. Unless that's what Mark's whole mission is here. If I encounter H.H. Holmes along this way, then that will triply confirm that there's multiple... dudes walking around. And that's how the wall closed, because there was another one. So we got the one following Jamie right now. And then there was another one that went to the control room to close the wall to separate Jamie and Kate. Thus, putting him into that situation. Okay! That's some shining shit right there. Oh, we finally just getting the fuck out of this place? An open window? Does that seem too convenient? And it's raining, slippery ledge. That could be death. Getting past that window real quick seems like a good idea. Okay, that was louder and more terrifying than I expected it to be. And happy that they give you that second and a half to... Ooh, no, did I miss?